Well, today is National Pecan Pie Day, so happy day to everyone because today we're celebrating with vegan pecan pie bars.
Love that. Emily Swedberg from Lucid Bakery is here, and someday we're going to get one of her hats as well.
Yes.
Welcome back to the show.
I'll make some for you.
Thank you.
Awesome. Thanks for having me. So happy National Pecan Pie Day. Can I tell you a dirty secret about myself, though?
Yes.
As a baker, I actually hate making pies.
Really?
I know it's so taboo, but it's just... Bars are just so way much easier because the crust isn't as picky as pies. So that's why these are great.
And I feel like they're easier to share too.
Oh,
especially
yeah.
with what
yeah.
people are going to. You're going to the lakes, you're going to people's uh-huh. houses for yeah. game nights.
Yeah, you can just pop one in your mouth. You don't need like a fork and knife and all fancy yes. stuff. So I'm excited to make these. Two things about them. They're egg and dairy free. So people that have allergies or that are vegan mm-hmm. can eat these. And also we're featuring handmade vanilla made by wow. one of my violin students, and we're going to be selling that at the market where I'll be at my
Ooh.
Booth yep at the Red River Market
this nice. Saturday
yep every Saturday
Ooh.
Yeah so come on by, we'll have different kinds of extracts including vanilla so
okay
all right should we get started?
I'm ready.
Well, let's turn on this guy and we're going to get started with the filling since it takes a little bit to cook.
Okay,
so we'll just add in basically all of this. So we have sugar.
So I did need this.
Yeah, we need that.
So brown sugars mm-hmm. first.
Brown sugar, oil, water, a little bit of flour, and some vanilla. And we're gonna wait to put in the pecans. But we don't use corn syrup in this, so it's a little bit healthier
That's
and a little
good.
Bit easier. And the thing I like about this recipe that I made is that most people should have all of these ingredients in their pantry already. You don't have to go to some specialty store to find
right.
these ingredients, which, yeah, if you're not gonna make it if you have to go out and buy something.
Right, it just yeah. sits as a recipe on your counter.
Exactly.
Like, yep. oh, I wish we would make this, but then
never
I gotta go to
it.
The store.
Uh-huh. So you're gonna be in charge of that.
Okay.
Just stirring around.
So how does your friend make the vanilla?
Well, there's a whole extractor process, and then you have real alcohol, and you just slowly kind of bring out the ingredients of the vanilla bean, or he's
nice.
Also making coffee. What else is he making? Oh, mint extracts.
Wow.
Is this
yeah.
the, what the vanilla was in? I
uh-huh.
can smell
yes.
this. Smell
it's
what's left.
So much more flavorful.
Holy
wow.
buckets.
Yeah, so it's
got a little
real
kick
deal.
To it
that
too.
Smells like you should be taking a shot of it.
It is made with alcohol, just like extracts.
That smells All really right. good though.
Well, let's get started on the crust, which is way easier than a pie crust, which I love. So we're gonna do the wets first. So the oils and the sugar and the water.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And then we're just going to stir that around until it's kind of mixed together.
Oh, thank you.
Uh-huh. I know I'm making you do a lot of the work today again, Chris.
This is very stressful. I'm going to need a big bite of that pecan
yeah.
pie after this.
Well, by the time we're done here, you're going to be an expert baker. So I'm just slowly training you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And then we can add the flour and the cinnamon and some baking powder in there.
You're a little nervous when I just start dumbing stuff, I can tell, huh?
She was just waiting for the cloud.
I can tell you're like, oh,
the
is he really
going to
just...
I know, we're all going to be white with flour. No, you're doing fine. That's what I love about this recipe. It's easy. You just dump stuff together and then put it in a pan and you're basically done.
Yeah.
So, yep, that's looking beautiful. You just mix that together until it's all incorporated.
Okay.
And then we're going to spread that in our pan. And you should be preheating your oven to 350. And we're going to bake the crust for a little bit so that it doesn't get soggy when we add the filling later.
Right.
Yes.
Because you need that good base for
yes.
all of the...
Can you show everybody what I did earlier this morning, please?
So Chris got up early.
Wait, why are you laughing?
Lisa may have covered storms. Chris was baking away in his kitchen.
I'm sure.
Did you hear her laugh, Larson?
I mean, I'm that sorry. Was like... it wasn't...
I think
it was
people
with
at
you.
Home were laughing, too.
Yes, Chris made this beautiful crust that we pre-made.
Look how perfect that crust is.
I know,
is
it really is.
Did.
Good job, Chris.
Thank
See,
you
I told
so
you'd
much.
Be a pro baker.
Expert
by the end
baker
of it.
Right there.
Yep, you're getting it.
Boy, this if I had some chocolate chip chocolate chips right now.
Oh, yes. Actually, pecans and chocolate chips go great. So
exactly.
Did you drink this vanilla before we went
no,
on?
No, he's an expert baker already, making his own recipes. I'm so
You're
proud of
you.
You're
going to add
Thank
chocolate
you.
Chips to this to have a chocolate
oh, it,
chip
look
crust?
It looks just
yeah,
like
yeah.
cookie dough.
Oh, yep,
so
yep,
good.
Exactly. So you actually just dump that in and we'll kind of spread it out. All right, I'll help you again.
Would it taste like cookie dough if I ate a bite of it?
Yeah, a little bit. It's just
oh,
not as...
Oh, don't tell her that, otherwise you're not going to have enough to spread around the pan.
And it's... Yep, it's not as sweet, but... You'll get the idea. It's basically the same as a sugar cookie. A little bit fundamental.
It's funny, it's not spreading out as easy as it did this morning.
Is that so, Chris, huh?
You know, it's different room temperature in here than probably when you were baking at
home. Different conditions.
Am I even remotely doing this right?
Oh, yeah, no, actually you're doing a really good job. I'm really impressed, actually. Look, that's kind of baker level 4 right there.
Yeah. He jumped from 1 to 4.
Right. Yeah, he's just... In like 3 minutes. That was really amazing.
Yeah, you're
See how good of a coach you are?
Yeah, no, you're the prodigy. All right, that's actually looking really great. So you just want to flatten it out because it's not going to spread like a cake batter.
Oh, right. Okay.
So you're doing that great. I didn't know you had practice this morning, so... and then basically, yeah, you just flatten it out and then we'll bake it for 20 minutes. And this crust is still flaky and not as sweet, so it's perfect like pie crust in a bar form. So you don't have to do the whole chilling the water and rolling it out and the whole
super crack. Easy.
Yeah, exactly. So that's our crust. And then we'll put that in the TV oven.
Yep.
And then we got
Bing.
This. Boop. It's done.
All right. Wow.
Look at that beautiful
magic
crust. Oh, and then we're gonna add the pecans to yours. Your mix right there.
Because this is pretty thin, actually. I was kind of surprised by that.
Yeah. But... And then as it bubbles, it's going to thicken up a little bit. Mm-hmm. So ideally, we have a few more minutes.
But I put these in now?
Yeah, you can put them in now.
Are you sure? It's not bubbling yet.
Oh, that's fine.
Okay. I don't want to ruin it. Chris is at baker level 4, and I've not even been introduced
to
level
1. You got to take risks. All right. And the what adds our little texture is actually saltines in our vegan pecan pie.
Are you just going to pound those right now?
I look like it, but no, we're going to be more gentle. So I'm going to have you do it.
Where are those going?
They're
going
to go in your mixture, actually.
What?
It's going to thicken it up a little bit. That's kind of the magic. You don't really,
okay.
A little baker secret. So just roll those out, and it's an easy way to crush something, like Oreos. Oh, you can do that too. Yeah, you can get aggressive.
He has some frustrations he needs to work on after waking up early to bake that crust for
baking
us.
Is therapy, so who needs to go to an anger doctor?
Is that good?
Oh, yeah, that looks good. So you just want
anything
from? Yeah, we'll dump that into the...
Because right now I got some just runny pecans.
Runny pecans, yep. And the more you kind of heat the sugar and the flour... And the oil on the heat.
That looks so weird to have crackers in there. I'm sorry.
You won't taste them.
I saw saltines and I didn't know what they were.
You're like, what the heck?
So it's thickening this all
up. It's gonna thicken it up. Yeah. So that's why we crumble them, so that it's just kind of a little added texture and it soaks up some of the sugar.
And it's not gonna like add too much salt or anything.
Oh no.
Because we added so much brown sugar anyway.
Yeah. It'll be, it's a nice combination of salty and sweet. And that's
listen to Larson's chemist mind work.
Well, I just.
Saltine crackers and are salty.
Well, yeah. Well, I mean, baking is all about chemistry, so you're on to something.
Ugh. Okay.
All right. Well, I think that's basically it.
You want me to put that on there?
Yeah. Let's just turn that off. After we kind of boil that a bit, then we're ready to just spread that on our crust.
So in reality, it'd probably be a little longer.
A little bit longer.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, while this is baking in the oven, we'll be making that.
This.
But yeah. But
okay.
With TV time, we're making it first. So it's going to be a little bit runny, which is what we want, because then it spreads across. And then when we bake it, it'll kind of solidify a bit.
That's like baker level 1 right there, Larson.
Thank you. My pouring.
No, I thought it was perfect pouring, Christy.
And then you go like this.
Uh-huh. Spread it a little bit. You can have a little bit of crust. That's totally fine. Exactly.
That looks really good.
Yeah.
This is Pinterest worthy, just so people know.
It does look gorgeous.
Or right. Instagram worthy.
Yep. And so it's that easy. And then we pop that in the oven for another 20 minutes. And then it'll be done.
And this
well
is
done,
what it
Larson.
Comes out
yep.
to.
So now we have some bars that we're going to actually top. We're not done yet. Just like the shortcakes that we did before. Here's yours.
Oh, they're heart plates.
I know. I love these plates.
Aww. Aren't they cute? Yeah. All right. So this is where we add our dollop of what I love, cocoa whip. And then a little bit of cinnamon. And I swear by this stuff. Like I could just eat it out of the tub.
Oh, that's right. It's your coconut.
This just get at the grocery store, because I was going to make the strawberry shortcake. And I was like, do I add cocoa to my whip?
Oh, no. Oops. You can actually buy this at the new food co-op downtown. Prairie Roots has all sorts of good alternatives for egg and dairy-free eating.
Nice.
Vegan stuff. So you can find that there. That's where I got it. And it's super delicious. But I'm going to do a pinch. You do a pinch.
Oh, thank you.
And that's just cinnamon.
Just add a little garnish.
I'm gonna do like this.
Oh, you're gonna just pour it on.
Well, just a little sprinkle.
That looks good.
Sprinkle.
All right, and then now, well, you could eat with a fork, but I just like to take a bite.
I was gonna say, weird.
Yeah.
This looks so good.
It's kind of crumbly, but with the cocoa whip, it kind of moistens it up.
Mm-hmm.
recipe will be up on ndtoday.tv. Thank you, Emily.
Thanks for having me. See you at the market.
We'll have more when we come back here on North Dakota Today.